This beautiful monstrosity is my homemade macro sliding device. And I made this because I could not find any existing products on the market that were optimized for doing camera motions on a high magnification macro scale. All the products I could find, all the sliders seemed designed for things like landscape time lapses or Hollywood type dolly shots. I could not find anything for high magnification where you can do extreme macro and not have terrible vibrations, and also have the ability to automatically transition between an A point and a B point with the acceleration and speed that I want. So that's why I built this thing. The main components we have here: open builds linear slider, pro aim dynamic wedge plate, which allows me to tilt the camera so I can have it make motions where it remains equidistant over a surface, which allows for some really cool shots. On here at the moment, I have a Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 4K. The lens is a Laowa probe lens, and those gray rings are lens stabilizers, which help to offset any small amounts of vibrations that may still occur. Here is an open build stepper motor, gold mount battery that powers all of this for several hours. And then the brains of the operation here is this control box, which I built myself. And inside of this box is an Arduino Nano with quite a bit of programming on it. And the actual device that moves the stepper motor is a DM542T stepper motor driver. And what is absolutely essential to all of this working is that that driver can do a high number of what are called micro pulses. So when you have the stepper rotating, it moves in pulses. That's how stepper motors work. And this DM542T in there can do up to 25,600 micropulses per rotation of the shaft of the stepper motor. And what that means is, as the stepper motor rotates, it does so very smoothly, like this. So smoothly that there's really no appreciable vibration. Whereas if you had it do, say, 400 micropulses per rotation, it would be like, you know, it would pick up on the shot. You would see terrible vibration. And I've tested that and the results look like garbage. So being able to do a high number of micropulses is absolutely essential. The downside is, because of limitations of the processor, the clock speed of the Arduino, I can only move this but so fast. If I had it set to a lower number of pulses, it could move substantially faster. So that's one downside, but since I'm doing macro with this and not huge motions anyway, the top speed that it does is perfectly sufficient for my purposes. So now I will go into the operation of this device. Press that lovely big fat red power button there to turn it on. We have this nice OLED screen with a little 3D printed cover that I made. So this first menu here is the Move Course menu, and as the name describes, this is where we would make big motions of the slider to set our A position and our B position. And the two ways we can do that is with this wheel, or if we hold this right button and then press the left button, we move left. If we press the right button and the center button, we move right. So it's a pretty nice logical way to control it, and it's very fast. If we want to set our A point, we would press this button here, which is our A button. And now our A point has been set, and this wonderful little blue LED light stays on for the remainder of when the device is powered. And then we move to the other position, let's say, to set our position B. And then we would press this button, which is the B button. So again, A button, B button, and then this would be the start or execute button, or in this case, a function button to control that movement. Next menu does pretty much the same thing, just on a finer scale. So if we need extra fine control of motion, we can do that with this mode. Very useful, I found. Now, when I built this device, I figured I might as well, in addition to video use, make it capable of doing focus stacks for still photography, which is where you take a bunch of pictures at different focus points of the same subject matter, and then in a computer, you would composite together the sharp part so you essentially get a massive depth of field. So this next menu, if I were doing a focus stack, this is where I would set the number of photographs. And pressing this left button sets it to 1. Pressing this middle button sets it increments of 10. And the right button increments of 100. For now, let's set this to 3. This knob, of course, does increments of 1. The next button here is the interval. This is the amount of time that it waits between photographs. So if you needed to do slow exposures in your focus stack, let's say of 10 seconds, you could do that. Similar deal to the previous menu, left button does 1, increments of 10, increments of 100. But let's just set that to 1 for now. Speed is the maximum speed at which the slider will move over its movement. The first button here is the lowest value that I allow on there, which is 100. The middle button is the default, which is 4,000. And the rightmost button is 8,000, the fastest speed that I can reliably get this to go. The next menu here is acceleration. So the default is 500, the lowest is 50, and the highest is 5,000. I find that 500 is a nice middle of the road value. Although, depending on the level of magnification you're doing, you might find that doing a smaller or higher level of acceleration produces a better image, especially when you're dealing with the stuttery qualities of 24p. And with all of these menus, you know, of course, I can also turn the wheel here to really dial that in by smaller amounts, but we'll leave it at the default of 500 for now. This is a cool little mode I put on here, invert knobs. So if I were to mount this control box on the opposite side of the camera, I can change that. And you can change this with the knob or, of course, with these buttons as well. And this is the one setting on here that is stored in the EEPROM of the Arduino. And what that means is if I turn the device off and turn it back on, the memory for that setting will be preserved. But for now, let's leave that to no. So our focus stack mode, the buttons we have here, this would go to our A position. So if we press that, it goes to position A. You can see it's gonna head there. If we were to press the B button, it'll go to position B. So that's a nice quick way. Let's say we were doing a focus stack of an insect's head. We can make sure that our different A and B points correspond to the front and back of the head. On the side of this box is a 3.5 millimeter jack, and that is programmed that if you hook up whatever kind of camera shutter cable you have, you can have it activate your camera's shutter. So if I want to activate this mode, I would press this right button here, the execute button. Now that it's already at position A, it's going to begin to stack. If it had been elsewhere, it would first move to position A, and it tells you which number you're on, in this case, 1 out of 3. Once it's done with the first shot, it will give you a time estimate of the remaining time for the stack you can see there at the bottom. And that's really useful because if you're doing, say, a 500 photograph stack, that can take a really long time, and it's nice to know how long it'll take so you can walk away. Once that's done, that menu will reset back to its default. And let's move on to the next menu. So this is the video slide mode. This is the mode I anticipate using the most. And similar to the focus stack mode, pressing the A button goes to position A, pressing the B button goes to position B, and pressing this button starts the slide. So if I press it, it's going to go automatically from wherever it happens to be to position A, and then it's going to wait 5 seconds and then do its motion from position A to position B at the speed and acceleration that I chose. Now, the reason I have it wait 5 seconds is if I'm doing a really high magnification shot where me standing nearby induces vibration in the camera, it gives me a chance to walk away. And I have that problem all the time if I'm filming on, like, you know, a wood floor, anything other than really solid concrete. It's a godsend to be able to do that. So now it's making its way over to position B, and then it nicely and smoothly stops. Lovely. So the next venue, in the last menu, is the knob focus mode. So sometimes you don't know exactly where you want the shot to end. You might not always want it to end right on point B. If you have dynamic moving subject matter, like let's say a moving insect, you might want it to stop a little bit short of B or maybe a little bit past B. So the way this mode works is it uses this knob here, and when you press the execute button here on the right, it's going to move the slider halfway between position A and position B, because at this point, the knob is in the halfway position. If I rotate the knob counterclockwise, it's going to move it in the forward direction, like so. And wherever I let off, it's then going to decelerate with that nice deceleration curve. And if I move it clockwise, it's going to move to the right or back. And the cool thing I programmed in here is it doesn't matter if our A point is at the back or our B point is at the back, or A is at the front, or B is at the back, whatever. Pressing it or rotating it counterclockwise is always going to go forward, and pulling it back this way is always going to make it go backward. And to me, that's just a sort of intuitive, logical, nice way to have it programmed. And of course, if you were to turn on the invert knob mode, that is all flipped. Now, as you might see here, there's quite a bit of delay between me turning it and it making its motion. And that's because the speed on this thing is limited. And remember, the speed's limited because of the clock speed of the Arduino. So if I go back into the menus again, and I select the maximum speed and the maximum acceleration, and then I enter that mode again, it becomes a decent bit more responsive. Now, it's still not going to perfectly match at real time the position of the knob because of the speed limitations, but for macro stuff, it's good enough. And when I let off, it nicely coasts to a stop. So, with all that said, I will now show you some examples of this thing in action.